On an Ender 3, some people like the spool on top. I don't because it hits my cabinets. I like it on the side, but some people think it's too wide. I think I found a compromise. I'll show you what it is on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. So here's the idea. Just mount the filament to the back. That's not going to work though, because then the filament's got to turn 90 degrees to go into the extruder. Or does it? See, it looked like the holes were symmetrical on the extruder around the motor. So I wondered if I could just turn that extruder 90 degrees so the filament is now coming in from the back and going out the front through the PTFE tube. It was worth a try. So I just turn it like this and then I'll bolt it back down and then the arm will come in here so the filament comes in the back. But would it hit this upper post? And to my surprise, the coupling clears it and so does the PTFE tube. But then I said, well, what about when it homes? Well, when I bring this home, it clears it. It doesn't get in the way. So now this thing can print like it normally would, but now I have the filament feeding from the back. Which means instead of filament on top or on the side, I can actually have the filament spool in the back here. And I don't have to stick it all the way to the back because I can bring it up in the air a little bit so it's not as deep. So I'm going to build this one up and show you how I did it. And then we'll try some prints. First thing I need to do is take off this arm. So all we need to do is unscrew this right here. Now we got three screws, 1, 2, and 3. So I'm going to start at the back here. Once I get those out, then I can just turn this 90 degrees and put them right back in. As you can see, there's a little bit of wear right here, and that's because this screw that holds the pulley was sticking out too much. So I added a little washer. It's actually a lock washer. It came with it. I never installed it properly. So I put it on there, and now this thing is flush, so it shouldn't wear anymore. So now I just need to install this, put the spring on, and then the screw. Now the filament will enter from the back. I'll just strap these wires up so they're out of the way. And then we need to make a new bracket so the spool holder is up here and will hold the spool like right about there. Well, I designed something in Tinkercad, so let me show you that. Here's what I created in Tinkercad. It angles back at 25 degrees. I've got slots at the top for the T-nuts, holes for the bolts, so you can bolt the existing spool holder right on top of this. I got two guides to go into the aluminum extrusion and an angled bracket to support it from the side. If we print against that angled bracket, it won't need supports. So let's print this and see how it turns out. And here's the design printed out. I used my 0.28 layer height profile, and I actually printed this on a machine that I had already turned this 90 degrees. So this print proves it does work because I printed a couple of these, one for the other machine and then one for this machine so I could show you guys. And it uses the same technique as my side spool holder. The T-nuts and the bolts are the same one that hold it to the top of the machine. Just slide the T-nuts in, screw it on, and then this just slides into the rail. Now I made this so it fits a little bit tighter than the side spool, but it still slides right on. So I'm gonna pull the end cap off, I'll slide this one out, and then we'll slide this one in place. And you can pretty much slide it wherever you want, what position, but it fits pretty tight. Then you put the cap back on. Now I gotta strap these wires up, but now you can see the spool sits up here. The filament can go straight in to the extruder. And the bed does not interfere with the spool. So now you can see it definitely goes a little deeper, but it's really not that much deeper. It's about maybe a little more than half the spool deep. And again, you can slide this a little closer if you want. So there's you gain a little bit of space, but it's definitely not as deep as it was wide with the side spool. And it's, you know, not as tall, obviously, because it's not on top. So let's hook this up and try it. I decided to just print another bracket for another machine. Here's the first layer going down. I used my CHEP 0.28 profile. It actually printed really nice and really clean, no under extrusion. Turned out great. Here's something a little bigger. It's a pencil holder vase. I did it in spiral mode in Cura with Atomics marble filament, and it came out perfect. No under extrusion, nice and smooth. The results look really good, and I like the footprint. It's definitely smaller than to the side or top. Now, I did notice I do lose a little bit of build area the way this is positioned, so I may have to redesign this bracket to shift this spool over a little bit, but that's just a design flaw. I can fix that. So I don't see a drawback to this, except for two things. One, you got to make sure that coupling is tight, because that back and forth movement twists it, and if it's not tight, it'll actually unscrew it. The other thing is you can't use an EZR extruder like I have on these back here. The EZR extruder is too deep, so it hits on this bar right here. So I'll have to make a bracket to shift the motor back if I want to use an EZR. But the stock extruder top, the plastic one, or this metal one works perfect. So I don't know, I really like it. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. If you like this video, maybe check out some of the other videos that are popping up and hit that subscribe button. That way you don't miss an episode. That's it for this week. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.